before the crews even got to him, kind of just sitting on top of his truck there waiting to be rescued. Now, whether or not he, I mean, obviously he knows that he probably shouldn't have gone down that road, needless to say, but all the fire trucks and all the emergency crews are on the other side, and they're kind of using their paddles getting over there, and then we're going to witness the guy getting off and getting into this
assuming he's the only one in the truck.
Sure.
You know, I mean, that there's not, you know, any more people in or around.
There's a life jacket as a precaution.
Of course. You know, you got that running water.
Sure. I mean, and we know our lifeguards, our firefighters, they practice for this kind of stuff under much worse conditions than this. But again, this is why the message always goes out to people. If you see water on a road, do not turn into it, because you really don't know just how deep it is and if any of the road is given way or if there's any dirt, and then you're going to get stuck. Because again, the water levels based on this pickup truck, you're looking at probably 3 to 4 feet in order to get that high up on this pickup.
Yeah, we're getting a location. If you're familiar with this area, the cross streets here are Saturn Boulevard and Sunset Avenue. There you see just a few moments ago, rescuers were able to get over to that pickup truck. They handed that man a life jacket, and the next move will be able to get him on that raft and off that truck. I have been, Raul, in situations like this when I lived in another part of the United States where there was a lot of flooding where I lived. It is really difficult because you get in these situations where you don't, it doesn't look like it's deep. It doesn't look like it's deep. You're like, oh, I can get right through it. And all of a sudden you find yourself in a pickle.
Mm-hmm. The National Weather Service says, don't drown, turn around. Mm. That's one of their catchy phrases that definitely makes sense. You don't only take 6 inches of running water to knock you off your feet.
And again, we make the point that when we have these big rainstorms, and you mentioned about 4 inches of rain fell in a short amount of time in this area.
Almost 4.5 inches in 2 days, the 2 day total.
And that's still a lot
in
a short amount of time. But we know when we get these storms in San Diego, we know the usual suspects in terms of the areas that are going to get this kind of flooding.
Yes,
Sorrento Valley. Tijuana River Valley is certainly one of them.
Yep.
Sorrento Valley, you mentioned, and of course there's the famous Bifashion Valley, that little road Bifashion Valley that always floods.
The San Diego River.
So they got this guy in this raft, and now they're kind of pulling away, and the truck, I'm assuming, will just stay there until the waters recede, and then they can try to get it out of there. But again, this is just a great example of why you should not drive into a flooded road when we have these storms. Thankfully, the conditions today were way better than they were just 24 hours ago for this rescue, if you want to call it that, I guess, or just going to get the guy and get him off his